Now then, welcome back. I'm George, this is Yorkshire. Welcome to Yorkshire. Right, a bit of change of pace today because it rained all day yesterday, so all ground saturated, little mini puddles everywhere. So a bit of change of plan is, you probably think what this thing is. And some of you might already know what this thing is. It's strimmer harness, weed whacker harness, and I've got a nice little weed whacker. Gonna do a bit of strimming and a bit of edges and see where we go from today. See if it dries out a bit. See if it dries out a bit, you see, because it's wet here. I've got my stand fixed as well. Happy days, look at that free hand. Hey, well, almost. My pile got saturated yesterday, so I don't know if you can see. Am I seeing this right? There. This is, you can see puddles that it caused yesterday. So I'm just going to do a bit of weed whacking. We'll get kettle on first and see where we go from there. See where we go from there, eh? Come on, guys. Come on. Come on, guys. Just opened off at chickens and little robin friend's gone in straight away. Look. Anyone see it, robin friend? There he is. Peek-a-boo. Peek-a-boo.
Cold start for me, little thing. Prime it. Pull on.
Right, and we're off. That's the engine started. Right, here's a little tip for you. When you've got a jerry can, right, most people pour it like this. They're not meant to be poured like this. If you pour it like that, air struggles to get into the bottle. They're actually meant to be poured this way around. I'll show you. Like this. This way, the air can get into the bottle and the liquid can get out. Because if you try and do it the other way, it glunks, like glug-glunk, glug-glunk, glug-glunk. And this way you have more control. Makes it easier for you. Hey. Nice and easy. Nice and easy.
Well, for all those that you can tell, I've, as you can see earlier, I strimmed all pastures, so it's, I've got rid of most of the weeds. Well, it's in most of them. Get rid of most of the weeds. Yeah. I brought strim around here and whacked all these nettles here as well. I've got all them whacked out. I just thought it'd make more sense. So again, all those with a keen eye, you'll see where I've done all this here. So all that there's been strimmed back. Yep. A bit more done. I did a bit more sieving here this afternoon. I managed to get a barrel full of rock piles before a whole load of rocks and twigs and stuff. Yeah, I managed to get a whole load of bricks and rocks and that together. A bit of glass in there, look. Pretty little glass. Some more, looks like a bit of an old glass bottle there.
Look at this for glass. Anyone seen glass that thick before? Anyone tell me what glass this is used for? It must be some old glass. I've just put it to one side because I think I might make some of that. I think it might be pretty. It's got our lass says it's got like a blue tinge in it. Right, I'm almost getting down to my level now, so I can get my footings put in properly. It's going to cost me about £90 for the materials I need to start with. That's to start with. And then we'll go from there. See how... Okay, my parsnips aren't doing too bad. I say my parsnips aren't doing too bad. Parsnips. They come up good, them, aren't they, this year? First time ever growing parsnips for me. I think I'm gonna have to put my hand in here before long and start de-weeding some of this, getting rid of some of these bits. All these have stood up lovely now, they've all come up lovely. You can see rain that we've had, still set up leaves. Right, now then, nice, I can't even say it. Right then, nice short day today. Forgot to charge the camera, so there's not much evidence of what I've done today. But done a fair bit on quiet. Don't forget to like, comment and subscribe. I'm George and this is Yorkshire. See you in a bit. Good night, guys. Thank you.